Hello, fellow Nightmare Seekers. It's Silent Signs from I Dream of Indie. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below so you don't miss any of our reviews or previews. Today, we are taking a look at Baobab's Mausoleum Grindhouse Edition, a game that comes to us from developer Celery Emblem and publisher Zerono Games. I played this one on Steam. It is also available on Switch, Xbox One, and PS4 with a release date of February 26, 2021. The price varies a little bit from console to console. Regular price on Steam is $16.99, though it is currently on sale until March 5th for $15.29. PlayStation Store and Nintendo Store have the game listed at $19.99, and the Microsoft Store has the game at $16.99 with no sale going on, at least not at the time of this review. This is going to be a difficult game to talk about because I don't even know where to start. Baobab's Mausoleum is part platformer, part RPG, part adventure game, and a little bit of everything in between. It's a little bit 2D, a little bit 3D, a little bit of a puzzle game. So perhaps the best place to start is to tell you what this game is not, and that is boring. Baobab's Mausoleum was previously released episodically, and this Grindhouse edition includes all three of those episodes. You can choose any of the three episodes to start on, though if you've never played any of the game previously, I would definitely recommend that you start with episode one, as that is where the story of Watrasio Walpurgis begins. WW, as I'll call him from now on because I'm pretty sure I mispronounced at least one of those names, is a vampire eggplant FBI agent that gets stranded in the town of Flamingo's Creek, which is a ghost town that only appears every 25 years, with his car totaled, his wallet gone, and no clue how to get out. All he wants to do is go home. But as you would probably expect, the wacky inhabitants of Flamingo's Creek aren't going to make that easy for him. Playing this one on Steam, I did have the option to either use keyboard and mouse or a controller. I, of course, chose a controller because I am incompetent when it comes to keyboard and mouse controls, but the controller didn't make things a whole lot easier. For the majority of gameplay, you're mostly going to be moving WW around using the directional buttons and interacting with objects and inhabitants using the action button. There are coins to collect, a very limited inventory system, and some light puzzle solving to attend to. But every once in a while, the game will throw an entirely different curveball at you, and you will be playing something unrecognizable. One minute you'll be playing something that looks like a 2D top-down Zelda game, and the next minute you'll be looking at some full-motion video and trying to decipher some alien heads. The best way I could describe this game to you is a complete descent into madness, and that's truly what it feels like. Baobab's Mausoleum is definitely a game that wears its inspiration on its sleeve. The developers cited David Lynch, Twin Peaks, The Legend of Zelda, and Day of the Tentacle all as inspiration for this title, and I can absolutely see it all. The twisted humor and the nonsensical puzzle solutions definitely reminded me of one of the classic point-and-click adventure games, while the story's more crime-related meets extraterrestrial beats definitely reminded me of something like X-Files or Twin Peaks. Pros and cons to Baobab's Mausoleum. Pros: this one will definitely get you thinking outside the box. You are not going to know what lies around the next corner, and you will learn to expect the unexpected. Cons: not all of it made a whole lot of sense, and sometimes the controls were a little bit iffy. I noticed particularly in menus that I had a hard time selecting something. For example, turning on and off the retro filter, I had to click it about 20 times to get it to work, and even then it would disappear when I went to the next screen. And even within the game itself, controls are a little bit slow and clunky, so if you don't have a whole lot of patience, maybe hold off on this one. Related to that, every episode of this game plays differently, and there's different types of gameplay even within a single episode. Not all are created equal. Some are absolutely brilliant, some are questionable at best. One thing that never let me down throughout this whole experience, though, is the art style. 10 out of 10, I loved everything about the presentation of Baobab's Mausoleum. From the very second I caught a glimpse of the garish colors in the intro, I was sold on the style of this game. The best way to describe the style is something like a 16-bit version of Rocko's Modern Life or Ren and Stimpy. It has that video game version of a cartoon aesthetic, and I am 100% here for it. But of course, that changes as the game progresses as well. Some images are actual photorealistic images, like a picture of a frog. Sometimes you get full motion video, sometimes you get a 3D scene. I was definitely the least enthusiastic about the 3D scenes in this game because they did in fact make me motion sick. This game is trying to be so many things, and I think that's part of the beauty of it. Even the parts I didn't like, I appreciated as a part of the whole. Keeping with the theme of a little bit of everything, the soundtrack is also just a piece of art. Again, right from the get-go with the intro to this game, you have this beautiful surf rock almost sounding with a little bit of theremin thrown in and some foreign vocals and some screaming. It's just pure brilliance, and that carries through the whole game. You will get things that sound like circus music and some rock tunes and everything in between. On the other hand, and in stark contrast to both the visuals and the soundtrack, the sound effects are very repetitive and got on my nerves almost immediately. I'm talking in the selection screen for which episode I was going to play. You hear a duck quack and a cawing sound, and that's it. I could have done with mixing those up a little bit more. It's not a deal breaker by any means. I do wish you could at least turn those sounds down, as they did get grating after a while, but beggars can't be choosers. Even with its pain points though, I can't hate on Baobab's Mausoleum Grindhouse Edition because it was such a fever dream and, like I said, a complete descent into madness, and you really feel it going from the first episode to the last one. It starts off weird, don't get me wrong, but it just keeps getting weirder, and I am here for some weird. I have to give this developer credit where credit is due. They will try anything, and they did try everything here in Baobab's Mausoleum. There is so much variety to gameplay here. Not all of it works well, and keep that in mind, but darn it, they tried. I would recommend this to anyone who is a connoisseur of the weird and wild side of gaming, those who like to think outside the box with their gameplay, and those that don't get too frustrated with shoddy controls. So what do you think? Are you gonna get weird with an eggplant? Let me know in the comments below. Before I go, I just want to give a quick shout out to our indie warriors Mitchell Hall, Kevilo, Bunny, Bill Tikaz, Christian Cruz, Wesley William Semple, Kimberly H, Rosie Syntax, and Chris Jackson. Thank you all so much for your support, and thank you all for watching. If you'd like to find out how to become an indie warrior, check out the description box below, and you could also find a bunch of other ways to support the channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next video.